Hi, everybody. I'm Dottie West, along with Mr. Ralph Emery, and it's the Ralph Emery Show.
Dottie, welcome again to our little get-together here. I hope you're doing all right.
Oh, I'm fine.
I'll just put in here that Bayer Aspirin is one sponsor for that mean old headache.
And Ford Trucks,
Ford Trucks, if you want to ride smooth. Who's going to open the show?
Well, I believe that we got Billy Crash Craddock from over in Charlotte, North Carolina. And he's going to do just a little thing.
Got a little something for you in my pocket. Don't light up like a bulb in a socket. It's just a little thing, baby. Woo! Just a little thing, huh? A little diamond ring. Called you everything to me. I sit down, close your eyes, say please. Ready or not, open up, I'm down on my knees. Cause it's just a little thing, babe.
Just a little thing,
huh? But if you wanted to, well, it belongs to you tonight. Oh, let's get it.
Opening our show, Billy Crash, and Just a Little Thing.
Now this from Sunrise 6 Productions.
The superstars of country music, 20 of the very best of the million sellers, such stars as Billy Crash Craddock.
Oh, my darling, knock three times on the ceiling if you want.
Johnny Cash.
Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Don Williams.
In the shelter of your eyes.
Tommy Overstreet.
How can I face her?
Sammy Smith.
Help me make it through tonight.
You'll also get the Statler Brothers, Roy Clark, Tom T. Hall, Donna Fargo, and Johnny Rodriguez, 20 superstar artists in all. To order yours, send $4.95 to Country Lovin', Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. That's Country Lovin', Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee, 37202. When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's rest, fluids, and Bayer aspirin. In my parents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was rest, fluids, Bayer aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed. Well, before I like to do things as I think of them, Dottie. So, Dottie, welcome back to the show. Now I'll tell another story, all right?
All right, fine.
Now, Johnny Rodriguez is going to be our guest in a couple of weeks. And I played golf with Johnny the other day, and he had never picked up a golf stick in his life. And now he's hooked. Now, for the ladies in our audience or some of the men who don't follow golf, this won't mean a thing, but to the golfers it will. John had never picked up a golf club, and he's quite athletic. And he has a black belt in karate and so on. And he exercises all the time, quite muscular. But he shot about a 65 on the front nine, first time he'd ever played. And on the back nine, he shot about a 52. And
which is quite remarkable for somebody who has never played golf. But now he's hooked. Gone out, he bought his wife, Linda, a set of clubs, and he's bought a set of clubs, and yeah, he was using Tom T. Hall's clubs the first time out. But he's hooked. Do you play golf?
I just started.
Oh, you have just started?
Just started. I've been out one Sunday about 5 weeks ago, and I'm hooked, but I almost... I really got spilled that day on one of the carts. Like to did me in, so I've had to wait a while to get back out.
What
it's
happened?
Not really funny. I still have bruises. My son Dale is just a little guy, but anyway, he golfs pretty well. You know, he started last year. So I was out there with him, and I'm letting him drive the cart. And he just... To make a long story short, he turned a short curve and sort of panicked and just about flipped the machine, really. But it turned it too quick,
mm-hmm.
Hit the gas instead of the brake, and it just flung me out of there. Gang, I went flying right down on my stomach on the pavement, and I still have two bruises on my hip, and I've got a skinned knee and an elbow.
Did it make you want to give up the game?
Oh, no. I love it. I'm going back out.
What did you shoot?
I just haven't had the chance since then. I was really just driving a little bit. Not the cart. I was just driving a few balls. I'm not into it that much yet, but I really plan to. So I just mentioned this only yesterday to somebody that I was, you know, getting started. And I've been invited to the Houston opening, and I don't know what I'm going to do.
I think I'd better
take my guitar. No, I haven't decided that
I
will.
You're going to play in their pro celebrity golf tournament?
End of May, yeah. I don't know if I will or not. I'm still debating.
Well, shoot, I'd go.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to be a dummy. I don't want to just go out there. I want to.
No, play.
I love sports.
Tell me you've never played in your life. See, and everything that you hit accidentally, they'll go ooh and ah.
Maybe
see,
I could have some beginner's
luck. See, if you go down and tell
them
you've played, then they'll put your plan down.
Yeah.
So use the other approach.
Well, I'm playing softball again this year during fanfare.
Well,
I love sports.
Let's do a tune here.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Or did you just really talk?
Oh, this one? I imagine the folks would like to hear some music. And I hope that they don't mind listening to this one again. It's been played a few times, but I'm glad that you still remember it, Ralph. It's called Here Comes My Baby Back Again, and it goes back to 1964 and 5.
Won a Grammy, too, didn't it?
Right. And the last, I've had quite a few people record this. There's over 100 now that other
Mercy.
Folks that have recorded. I wrote this one night in Kansas City, Missouri. And it was like in 10 minutes, I sat down on the foot of the bed and just in the motel after work and just almost sang it straight through without working on it. It was like it was God-given, or I'd sang it before almost. Anyway, the latest recording on it that I've heard is Billy Joe Spears. It's in her new album. And I think she sings it so good.
You were over, weren't you, at RCA one day and happened to walk in and somebody was recording this song? Because I think I was in the building at the time. But I don't remember who it was.
Yes, Margie Singleton.
Was that you?
Margie Singleton.
But isn't it nice just to walk in without any, without
oh,
even
yes,
knowing
and I didn't
somebody's
know it.
Going to record your tune, and there they are singing it.
The best story I have on this, really, is when Perry Como did it. Chet called me and called me at home, and he said, Dottie, I think there's somebody down here you'd like to meet. Why don't you just come on down to my office? Well, now, it doesn't matter what you look like or what you're doing. When Chet calls and says, why don't you just come on down to my office, you drop it and you get on down there, you know. So, everybody has this kind of respect for him, and I think they should. So anyway, I immediately got it together and went on down to Chet's office, and when I walked in, there sat Anita Kerr, and the most beautiful hair I've ever seen on a man's head.
I thought you were going to say on Anita Kerr.
No, well, she's beautiful too, but Perry Como just has such gorgeous hair, and I remember seeing that first. But anyway, Perry says, hello, Dottie, I plan to record one of your songs that you've written, and it's nice to know you, and it just really was one of the biggest thrills of my life.
Goosebumps.
I can think about it and get goosebumps. That was a few minutes that will always be with me.
Well, let's go back to about 2 minutes and 30 seconds of something that will always be with you, too.
Okay.
Our guest star of the week, Dottie West, and her classic, Here Comes My Baby, back again. Harlan Howard once said, and he's a great songwriter, he said, I would rather write a standard than a hit any day.
That's what this song is.
It's become an American standard.
It's never been that big smash like a Behind Closed Doors.
When you handed out, how high did it go in the charts?
It was number two.
Well,
Tiger by the Tail was hot right then, and I ain't no way I could yank him out of there. It was just, that was what kept it from being number one.
A classic.
It became number one in a couple of the trades, but Tiger by the Tail kept it from being number one in Billboard. That was what it was.
Well, you got 100 recordings out of it. That's not too bad.
Elvis, what's his name, didn't do it yet, though.
Well, maybe.
He told me he might sometime. And
maybe
he will. I sure hope so. Wouldn't that be nice?
I think it'd be splendid. Can we bring on the next song here?
Yes.
All right, we're going to kick the tempo considerably. Here's Hank Williams, Jr.
The boogie woogie when I'm in town. I mean Mobile, down in Alabama.
Down in Alabama,
where the breeze is blowing, that's where I'm bound.
Boogie woogie, woogie,
woogie, woogie. This is the reason I'm saying goodbye. I guess the ones I met, I'm ready to cry. Everybody's been so nice to me. I hate to leave you, but I gotta go see good old Mobile, down in Alabama.
Down in Alabama,
where the breeze is blowing, that's where I'm bound.
Hank Williams, Jr. doing a very old country song made famous by the Delmore Brothers some 30, 40 years ago called the Mobile Boogie. And now here's a word about a nifty 150, the new 77 Ford F-150 pickup truck. You own a ranch or farm or just want a smart-looking pickup to tool around town in? Ford's got your number, F-150, a tough truck made even tougher this year. New high-efficiency V8s designed for extra reliability. New anti-corrosion measures that include fender liners front and rear. New low-schedule maintenance needs and more. You can choose from two-wheel drive or 4x4s that make their own roads and run on any kind of gas, regular, premium, or unleaded. Have a big crowd to tote around? Then maybe you want an extra roomy F-150 workhorse, that family-size Ford Super Cab, America's roomiest two-door pickup. Whatever you pick, you've got yourself one tough truck. Just how tough? Well, 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. So get yourself down to your Ford dealer and check out that F-150. It's the huskiest half-ton Ford has ever built. All right, Dottie, bring on the next singer here.
All right, she's from the same label I record for, United Artists. Her name is Crystal Gale, and she sings so fine. I'll do it all over again.
Was I right? Was I wrong? A little too weak, a little too strong. Was it him? Was it me? Oh, I guess I'll never know. Well, you're up, then you're down. Oh, but the world keeps turning around. Ain't it hard to find something to hang on to? But I know that my heart will mend, and I know that I'll smile again. I'll get back on my feet, and then I'll do it all over again. Some you lose, some you win. They say that's the way it's always been. First you laugh, then you cry. Oh, but I guess that's life. So you live and you learn, and never look back at the bridges you burn. And you change somehow. Oh, I'm a little bit wiser now. But I know that my heart will mend, and I know that I'll smile again. I'll get back on my feet, and then I'll do it all over again. But I know that my heart will mend, and I know that I'll smile again. I'll get back on my feet, and then I'll do it all over again. I'll do it all over again.
Pretty, a pretty thing there. Crystal Gale, she pretty?
Oh, she's beautiful.
Singing I'll Do It, huh?
And she has such pretty poise on stage. I love the way she handles herself on stage while she's singing. I think she's, I think all the guys like it too.
Yes, yes. I don't know whether they've noticed her poise yet or not, but they sure notice her. You've heard Crystal sing.
Beautiful.
I'll Do It All Over Again. Friends, let me tell you about one of my favorite things. It's the country music newspaper, Music City News, the only major country music publication that comes from Nashville. Every month, you get to read exclusive interviews with country music stars, album reviews, new record releases, behind-the-scenes stories, visit the stars' homes, and there are lots of pictures, but very important, something no other country music publication has, Music City News lists when and where you can get to see future personal appearances of the stars. You too can become a part of the country music scene by subscribing to Music City News. Subscribe now by enclosing your check for $8, and you'll be saving more than 20% off the single copy price. And in addition to that, for acting now, you'll get a baker's dozen. That's 13 issues for the price of 12. So rush your check for $8 today to Ralph Emery, Post Office Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. Well, I'm sitting across this pretty redheaded gal, Dottie West. Did I embarrass you today when I came by your house?
I was afraid you'd mention that. He came by my house, folks, to pick up some tapes of my new album that we would need tonight for the show. And I thought, sure, he would go to the door.
Front
door. The other door, you know, not the front door. You don't have to go around there. Everybody uses the back door downstairs. But no, Raph bounces right on up on the sun deck. And
there
I
she
was
is.
Laying there getting some sun. And
don't tell him anything else. Just cut it off right there. I want them to use their imagination. Here's Tom.
I had on an orange swimsuit.
Here's Tom T. Hall.
Had my golf clubs on my shoulder when you saw me first today, wearing my old army sweater that you thought you threw away. And when you saw me standing there, you shook your head and sighed. When you saw I bought a six pack, I thought you were gonna cry. Your man loves you, honey, and I don't know what else to say. Your man loves you, honey, but you can't change my way. Now before you say you're angry, remember what I did. Went to church with you last Sunday, took your mama and the kids. Sat right up and heard the preaching, even wore my Christmas tie. I'm not much on organ music, five string banjo's more my style. Your man loves you, honey, and I don't know what else to say. Your man loves you, honey, but you can't change my way. Oh, you should have had a knight in armor and a castle fair, not some restless cowboy, faded jeans and shaggy hair. I can't make it, babe, without you, and you know that it's true. Keep me around for laughs, so I've been good for one or two. Your man loves you, honey, I don't know what else to say. Your man loves you, honey, but you can't change my way.
That's Tom T. Hall with Your Man Loves You, Honey. My guest is Dottie West. Dottie, it's your turn to sing again. Let's pretend we're up on the sun deck.
Well, oh, no, Ralph.
I went to Dottie West's house today to pick up some material for this album, and I didn't know where she was, you know, and the sun deck at her house leads in to the kitchen.
Or to the den,
and
right.
And you go in there, so. And I had been in that way before. And Dottie was sunning in her bikini. And as Grandpa Jones might say, trim little craft. Very, very lovely girl there. All of you. Oh. Did I embarrass you?
My face is red too, folks. It goes along with my hair right now.
What if I had a camera? I could, boy, among your fans, I could really get rich.
You could watch a redhead tear up a camera, couldn't you?
Yeah, you'd have tore the camera up.
No. This is a serious song that we're talking about.
Oh, what
it's
is
very
serious.
Serious.
What is serious about that?
I mean, it's, you know, it wasn't written to be funny or, I mean, it's a
laugh.
Serious message. No.
We shouldn't laugh while we introduce this?
No. Let me tell you how serious it is.
All right.
I wrote it one night in Bowling Green, Kentucky, and I was supposed to be in Bowling Green, Ohio. And there's something serious about that now.
You went to the wrong place.
Right. And nobody's perfect. So I just said, well, we missed that one, so we turned around and drove back home. And I just hope that Bowling Green, Ohio has forgiven me.
I've seen this happen to, Mo Bandy went to Greenville, South Carolina, instead of Greenville, North Carolina, where we were awaiting his arrival to do a show.
That hurts, and you don't get paid either.
Well, he made it.
Oh, did
somehow.
He? Well, this was 500 miles in between, so there was no way for me to make it. And it was, you know, about 3 hours before showtime.
Is that what put you in the mood to write this?
Well, maybe it was. I don't know. There was nothing much else to do but write a song and turn around and drive back home.
Were you afraid the promoter would hold it against you? Because you didn't make it to Bowling Green, Ohio?
Well, maybe that was it. I don't know. Somehow.
Let's use that. It's a nice way to get into the film.
All right.
Would you hold it against me if I just see him one more time? Just so I can make certain I can leave him behind. Would it make any difference if I just hold him once again? Now you know that I love you, but have I forgotten him?
against me.
If I just see him once again, then I'll know that I love you and that I've forgotten him.
Our guest, Dottie West, a pretty song called Would You Hold It Against Me?
We can laugh. I was teased a lot about it.
You were teased a lot about what?
About this song, but it was nominated for a Grammy Award, Would You Hold It Against Me? It was nominated for a Grammy, and I won a BMI Award as a writer, so.
Okay, I'm going to forget that tune now and go on to something.
Okay,
else.
Thank you.
I want to go back to the Sunday. Can I laugh now that we have played your tune? Mel Tillis.
You're laughing at me.
No, I'm not. I'm not laughing at you. I'm just in a good mood. Here's Mel Tillis to sing a song that he is reviving. Years ago, he wrote this for Ray Price. You may remember that.
Oh, right.
When he wrote this for Ray Price.
Mm-hmm.
Today, it is Mel's latest record. It's called Burning Memories.
Tonight, I'm burning old love letters. Photographs and memories of you. Hoping somehow I'll feel better. And when the smoke is gone, I won't want you. And when the smoke is gone, then I'll be free.
Tillis, and he's another upcoming guest on the show. Mel singing Burning Memories. When someone in our house has a cold or flu and wants relief from the aches and fever, it's Rest, Fluids, and Bayer Aspirin. In my parents' house, it was Rest, Fluids, Bayer Aspirin. In my grandparents' house, it was Rest, Fluids, Bayer Aspirin. Isn't it amazing? In over 60 years, medical science hasn't been able to improve upon aspirin. Three generations of doctors have recommended it. Bayer was the first aspirin, and today Bayer is still number one. Use only as directed. I'm going to play the recording by Loretta Lynn of She's Got You from the album I Remember Patsy. And I, when I first heard about this idea, I remember Patsy Cline very well, and I know you do. Mm-hmm. And I wondered if you had ever had this idea, because I know you were very close to Patsy Cline.
Right, and I've thought about it, but somehow, I'm glad that Loretta's done this, because Patsy deserved, you know, being remembered in this way. I mean, having a real tribute, you know, done for her, and she had such great songs. But every time I'd think about it, it really sort of bothered me. I don't know. I didn't feel worthy.
Now I know that Patsy Cline took Loretta Lynn under her wing, so to speak, and I got the impression she did the same for you.
She did. She paid my rent a few times.
Did she really?
She sure did.
You
I mean, literally.
You came to Nashville to set up shop in the early 60s when she was a big star, didn't you?
Right, and the first year after I moved back to Nashville to really try to make it, I got pregnant with my youngest son, and I really thought it was just the end of the world. I thought, you know, we had both, my husband and me both had quit jobs to move back here and really try to make it in the music business, and had not too much going, except it looked like we were going to get a writer's contract and a recording contract. But Patsy was just really a fantastic friend, and she really cared.
How did she know you couldn't pay your rent?
Well, she knew I wasn't working much on the road.
She come to you and ask you how things were going?
No, she'd... well, we talked. We were together a lot, so mm-hmm. we talked a lot. And the way she gave me a check one time, and I didn't know it until I'd gotten home. She gave me her scrapbook and asked me to keep it. Now, this is in 63, the year that she was killed. And 3 weeks before that, she gave me her scrapbook, the one that she'd kept of her, all of the things, you know, all of the charts, you know, of
all the honors that had come her way.
All of the honors and everything, you know, and write-ups and letters. And I still have the book, and I cherish it very much, and I'm keeping it just a couple more years, and I'm going to give it to Julie, her daughter, because I could give it to the Hall of Fame, and I've thought about all this, but I think that I was waiting till her daughter was old enough to really appreciate what it is, you know, and would keep it. And I'm going to give it to Julie. But anyway, and the reason I got into that is, in the book when I got home was a check, and a little note said, "I know you're having it rough, pay your rent."
Oh, that's nice.
I sat down, needless to say, and cried real good, and I called her back and tried to give it back to her, and she said, "No. What are friends for?" And she would make you
She had a pretty strong will, too, when she
made did. She could. There was times she was down, and she really needed people like Loretta and Brenda and me. I mean, Patsy would get like this, and she really needed people around her.
Dottie, I'm going to cut you off. I need to go on to the song here. But I knew you were very close to her. This was one of her hit songs, and it's sung here by Loretta Lynn.
I've got your picture that you gave to me, and it's signed with love, just like it used to be. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got your picture, she's got you. I've got the records that we used to share, and they still sound the same as when you were here. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got the records, she's got you. I've got your memory, or has it got me? I really don't know, but I know it won't let me be. I've got your class ring that proved you cared, and it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing
thing different. The only thing new. I've got these little things. She's got you. I've got your memory. Or has it got me? I really don't know. But I know it won't let me be. I've got your class ring that proves you care. And it still looks the same as when you gave it, dear. The only thing different, the only thing new. I've got these little things. She's got you.
Loretta Lynn singing Patsy Cline's hit, She's Got You. All right, we are going to bring on, I guess, the sequel to Roll On Big Mama. Here's Joe Stampley.
She's long-legged. She rolls through the night like the wind. She whispers in my ear, tells me of the places she has been. Knowing that her shadow, the last of a dream, nearly gone. She's long-legged. She's always moving me on. Well, the highway signs move her on with a big iron shaking to a lonely song. All 18 is a making her sing. Drive line flying from a big machine. And the road we run till the setting sun, and it's shining in your face when the day is done. Feel a little better cause we made some time. The lady is moving on down the line. She's long-legged. And Lord, we go on, come rain or shine. I reckon she is timeless, just knowing she's the last of her kind. She acts like a woman, moving her body to your song. She's long-legged. She's always trucking me on. Well, the highway signs will move her on with a big iron shaking to a lonely song. All 18 is a making her sing. The drive line of fun from a big machine. Lady is moving me down the line. She's long-legged trucking. She's long-legged. Roll on, big mama. She's long-legged.
That's Joe Stampley, another good truck driving song called She's Long-Legged.
Here's Merle Haggard and big news about Ford pickup gas mileage.
Hey, pickup driving man, are you in luck? Ford's got your kind of a real tough truck. It's a strong running, long running, smooth as a song running pickup with a proud Ford brand. Made tough for the pickup driving man.
Whatever you pick, you've got yourself one tough truck when you own a Ford F-150. Just how tough? Well, 93 out of 100 of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years are still on the job. Compared to our nearest competitor, a higher percentage of Ford trucks are still out there running after 12 years, 13, 14, even after 15 years. So get yourself down to your Ford dealer and check out that F-150. Dottie, how far are we going back now for paper mansions?
This is 1966.
So about 11 years.
Right.
And you were cooking those days with this tune?
Don't live for me. No paper mansions that only stand until you've gone. You paint the nicest futures of anyone I know. You always leave me holding on to pretty words that glow. You build a thousand mansions out of dreams that seem so strong, but they're always made of paper, not of stone. Don't build for me no paper mansions that I can never call my own. For love can't live in paper mansions that only stand until a dreamer too, but I guess I've had too many of the kind that don't come true. So don't build me no mansion with paper walls so thin that only stand until you leave again. Don't build for me no paper mansions that I can never call my own. For love can't live in paper mansions that only stand until you've gone.
Our guest star of the week, Dottie West, another of her hits, Paper Mansions. Well, we've had almost got Dottie crying on this show. We've got to talk about Patsy Cline. I'm sorry about that, but maybe we'll pick up a few more memories tomorrow that'll make you happy.
Oh, there's some good ones there, too.
Dottie, thank you so much for being our guest.
It was fun.
Our show presented by those dependable Ford trucks. Go by and look them over soon at your Ford dealers. And by Bayer Aspirin. Thank you very much for listening.